Yeah, it's a naturopath all the way from down the bottom of the world, New Zealand. Eric Backer is my name. Thank you for tuning in. If you're new to my channel, please check out some of the playlists. There are a lot of videos on this channel, and we've been working on this channel now for about 5 years, and I'm quite proud of it. There's a lot more to come, so stay tuned, especially if you like cooking and eating and lifestyle and stuff like that. I'm going to do a lot of stuff next year. My clinical practice ceases end of November 2019. And we're going to take a long break with Tracy, and then when we come back, we're going to be doing some really cool stuff next year. We've also got some travel in mind, and I want to do some travel stuff with people too. My mum was very interested in travel and cooking, and so am I. So I hope to do something from some crazy countries like Vietnam or places like that. So it's time for me to step out and do stuff instead of sitting on my butt. Okay? Right, let's talk about hunger and bacteria. I've read so many studies now on this topic, and it's so exciting to see that many bacteria are involved, okay, in stimulating appetite or decreasing appetite, in making a person feel full or empty. But finally, lots of research, and particularly when we look at the gene sequencing, how we can now do advanced DNA studies on bacteria and like advanced and detailed experiments on mice and rats and extrapolate to humans, we're starting to see huge connections on the balance of the microbiome and also on the person's ability to want to eat food or not want to eat food. We're actually noticing common bacteria like Escherichia coli or E. coli, which everybody has. They're starting to see now that bacteria like this can actually produce proteins which can stimulate or decrease appetite. But it all depends on the balance of the bacteria in the gut. To me, as I've always maintained, the human gut is no different from a garden. Everything happens in balance. If you disrupt that balance, you create a problem. It's one of the reasons I never use any chemicals whatsoever in my garden and never have for decades. And the reason I don't want to do that is because I want to keep the whole yard as an ecosystem. When people visit my garden, they're astounded at the insect life. In fact, I'm also introducing some New Zealand insects to the garden that are quite unique, and I'll show you a photo of these insects, and you'll probably find them quite freaky if you live outside of New Zealand. The reason I'm doing this is to create ecology, to create a balanced system. Now let me look, here it is here. Now here's a picture of a lady holding what's called a weta. You can actually see the weta here. See these big kind of like really huge, crazy looking creatures here? Let me hold it back a bit. So these insects are big flightless crickets indigenous to New Zealand. Now I want to get them in the garden because they really help also to break down leaf litter. But, you know, as per usual, if there's any like rats or stoats or ferrets, we've got to trap and get them out. We don't really have a problem. What am I talking to you about all this for? It's about the balance. I love getting insects in my garden because I know that they form a very powerful part of the ecosystem and they keep the natural or the pests under control. So when people look at my plants, they don't see bugs eating stuff because I've got wasps, you know, natural wasps that predate on these bugs. Now, in your gut, it's no different. When you've got the balance of that ecosystem happening there, you get really nice, healthy levels of Escherichia coli that start to behave the way that these bacteria should behave. They don't have big egos like some politicians have, okay? They stay under control. And this means also that the key hormones produced in your gut are much more regulated and balanced because bacteria make many different types of proteins and other factors which manipulate hormones. We've even found that bacteria can directly influence neurons in the brain with very complex, you know, pathways. But the balance is extremely important. If you're always hungry and you can't work out why, make sure that you have got no yeast overgrowths in your gut or no massive big small intestinal bacterial overgrowths. If you bloat and fart and have bowel problems and are hungry a lot, particularly you really want to get onto the gut and tame this beast, okay? So can you swallow crickets and bugs and put natural predators down there? Yes, you can, okay? You can eat good food. You can eat lots of fresh produce because this fresh produce will stimulate the production of lots of bacteria in your gut, many different types. And lo and behold, you may even do something crazy and eat foods you've never eaten before and encourage other bacteria back that have may long been killed off, right? Many people worry about a big population decline in their digestive system of bacteria. But don't worry, okay, because there are always bacteria there. And there are usually tiny little pockets of bacteria that want to come back if they're coaxed out of their hiding hole by food. So by constantly eating good food, by understanding the principles of stress, sleeping more, eating better protein, more natural fats, drinking water, all of those things you can do, you're going to get the natural balance back, right? And that means that you're going to have appetite control. And that means also you're not having any bloating, no farting, normal bowel motions, all that kind of stuff that I try and really get happening in patients. And you can get it too. And when you finally get to that point, you'll think to yourself, oh, I've lost 10 pounds. That wasn't hard. And I didn't do much for it. And that's because you're living according to the laws of nature. And when you work with Mother Nature, she's going to really take care of you. But when you flaunt those laws and pump chemicals and antibiotics, like me spraying glyphosate all over the place, and I've got a neighbor two doors up, everything's sprayed. It's gross. When I go and visit his garden, it's a terrible garden. It's just literally like a graveyard. You can't see anything there. He just sprays everything. That to me is like a video I just did on intravenous antibiotics. You're going to create this disgusting situation in here and then wonder why modern science can't fix you up. Modern science needs to take a long, hard look at nature. That's why. Thanks for tuning in. Click on the link if you want my free weight loss report. Thank you.